588 points. Présentons la Corée, representing Korea, Chaeyun Kim.
Merci, mesdemoiselles et messieurs, de nous avoir accompagnés, ces deux compétitrices, et on vous retrouve tout à l'heure.
And we are back. First match of an all-Korean recurve women's final. Bronze medal match between Wee Nayeon and Kim Chaeyun. And Rio, we've seen a lot of the Korean women's recurvers here the last few years. We're going to see a couple more after this. What do you think makes them so strong indoors especially? I mean, they always do well outdoors, but indoors you often see a four-woman Korean final.
I think a lot of it is they started a few years ago, and it's kind of, I think, actually helped them mentally. Indoors is a little different. But she starts off with a 10. You're just seeing here a little different. We have a little bigger target for the recurve, and it's a set system, so it's a little different scoring. And so the crowd gives it in for a 9.
Yeah, they just can't have it,
I mean, you expect, the hard part is when they expect things of you. I mean, it's like, now she gets the
Now we've got the crowd enjoying themselves a little bit. They've loosened up. Yeah, so tell us about the recurve set system, how we're going to look at scoring this match.
Three arrows, and they get 2 points for a set win or one for a tie.
Right.
And the first one to 6 wins. So it's a little different than the compound where they get straight scoring.
It's more like tennis scoring here.
It's kind of integrated into that, a little bit of a different way of doing it.
So set one, they're going to split. They're each going to take 1 point.
Yeah, as you can see, they got 1 set point apiece. And it adds up. To the first one to 6 wins. You know, if they end up with 5, it's a 1-arrow shoot-off.
Right.
That extra set point. It's a neat format. It keeps them really close. Can, you know, not affect you if you have a bad arrow. It's
right.
Bad, but
recurve, you know, much different game from compound. Bad shot in a compound for one of the elite archers here on the stage is going to be a 9. Bad shot for a recurve archer might score a 7-8. It's hard to say. So it doesn't, the set system doesn't allow one arrow to totally kill the entire match.
Yep.
At the same time, it doesn't always let the best archer truly pull away.
Yep. It keeps it close.
Yeah. But for our viewing benefit, with recurve especially, this is a great way to watch a match.
Yeah, and this will be a good one. I mean, these gals shoot against each other a lot. They're competitive. They're different teams. They have corporate teams over there.
Right.
And that's what's kind of cool is they brought them in. And like I said, I do think it's helped them mentally at the games. Because you watch, you know, a few years back, it's been a little while, but they started doing these World Indoor Cups, and I think it's really helped them. Mm-hmm. Teams.
Yeah, absolutely. And in our, not to get ahead of ourselves, but in our next match, we are going to see the 2016 Olympic champion.
Yeah.
9 for Miss Wee.
Got a close one.
The one thing I notice about the Korean women, their shot is fairly quick. There's not a whole lot of wasted motion and virtually no wasted time. It almost always looks a lot like what you just saw there in terms of the anchor, the setup, the anchor, and then the timing on the shot.
Yeah. Their shot time is usually pretty consistent.
1 to 2 seconds and it's out the door.
Yeah.
And you don't want to necessarily step up and shoot fast, but you want to shoot under the rhythm and timing that you are accustomed to. Yes, so. The Korean method has been developed into this, and like I said, it doesn't allow a waste of energy, and you don't have a breakdown of the shot.
Yep.
I've seen one Korean woman who really kind of ventured away from that kind of timing, and it was Kibo Bae, who two-time Olympic individual medalist, one-time gold, one-time bronze, and then a couple of team golds as well. So no one's going to argue with her results.
No, but this, well, the set system now, her shooting the higher score, she ended up with 2 set points now. So she's 3-1.
3-1.
Which can sound like a mile with the little points, but it's really not that far.
Yeah, that can turn around real quick. Yeah. And even then, she, you know, we are going to have a deciding win here in this set. So no matter what, they're going to shoot 2 more sets.
Yeah. And, you know, I mean, just like say, you just don't know how nervous somebody is out there, what they're thinking, what's going on, what's in that realm. And these are, Korean women are some of the best in the world, period. Their teams are stacked. They have a lot of talent. They,
you know, like I said, we often see four of them in the finals at events like this.
Yeah.
And the fact is, you know, at an outdoor World Cup, they can only have four total. At an Olympics, they only have three total.
Yeah.
If you were to just line up everybody in the world in women's recurve, you know, at least 50 of the top 100 are going to be from Korea.
Yeah,
it's so deep, the talent pool.
Yeah. Well, it comes from coaching, from their the way they do their things. They're starting out good. This is a good set right here. Now she hopes for a 9 here. That's the worst part, having to hope that your competitor shoots a 9 so you have a chance.
Right. She smoked it right down the middle.
That puts her in a pretty decisive 5-1.
Yep.
You split the set and still win the match. It's a pretty comfortable place to be in.
Yeah. So as you saw with the recurve, they shoot a little bit different target. The 10 ring is twice the size of that in the compound, so it's 4 centimeters across. Everything else remains the same. Distance is the same. And then as we detailed earlier, the scoring and the match format is slightly different. But as it was in compound, the trailing archer will start the end, start the set first. So again, we're at 5-1. Miss Wee now must win this set. A tie will not do her any good. If she ties this set to Miss Kim, yeah, the match is over at 6-2. So she's got to win this set or the match is done.
Yeah, this is one of the toughest positions to be in because you have to
hope. Yeah.
Yeah. And it's not ideal to be in this position.
If you're around this game long enough, you hear of the match that went 30-29 and then 30-30-30-30.
Yeah,
yeah, you just gave up the one and then you never did again, but it didn't matter.
Well, there's your door open.
Yep. They're saying that one's a maybe. That's a big maybe at this point. Yeah.
And that's, like I said, hope. Mm-hmm. Hope is your biggest.
Smooth shot there, but out the right.
Yeah. And you got to do your job to have that hope even be worth anything.
Mm-hmm.
Another good shot.
Notice a lot of the recurvers shoot the smaller diameter arrows. East and X-10, same arrows they shoot outdoors, they shoot them indoors. They have a little tougher time getting the larger diameter arrows to tune properly out of the bow. And what do we got here? So this arrow call is very pivotal.
As of right now, it says 3-5, but depending on the arrow call.
Right. And we'll go back into that
arrow.
Talk about arrows later, but this right now,
the crowd's getting into it.
We're waiting on one arrow call that will decide whether this match continues or not. The judge is using his magnifying glass.
Thought you get the head nod from the agent down there. I'm guessing it's in, so that'll give her the win or the tie.
He calls it. That arrow moved to a 10. Miss Kim is your bronze medal winner.
Well, it's nice sometimes you have an agent trained or knows to tell you when you've missed or not. You know, it's like, hey, the thought quicker than then get it on the board or anything, because you know as well as I do, the shooter, you're a little nervous to find out what that arrow is.
Yeah. You want your agent to turn around and give you the thumbs up or the thumbs down, whether it's in or out.
Head shake, dance, whatever you want.
Something, yeah. So
that gives her the bronze medal, and that'll do the gold medal.